Hi folks, today we discussed a panel that used a VFD driver from the PCT with the reference PT6315-S. The score S stand out because it referred to a DIP 24 model instead of the traditional LKFP 44. In addition to its difference in the encapsulation, it varies its control capacity between the 4 grids, 12 segments, up to 8 grids and 8 segments. In this code example, we will use the bitwise process to send comments and data, but in everything identical to what we usually use. In this panel that display the models for Symphony Philips Emerson, the VFD reference is TVFD150FT007 from Futaba is used. The service manual is available on the web related with the device of the Philips. As it is evident, it is not possible to represent all alphanumeric characters, so a short loop for the four possible words is left without consuming time with the libraries in order to make the example as simple as possible. To power up the panel, we make use of the 2 5 volts DC power cells. Here is one power source of 5 volts, which is responsible to provide the power to the converter DC-DC from 5 volts DC to 24 volts DC. At the same time, through two diodes, when 404, for example, provide the voltage to the filament, because here in this diode will drop 0.7 and here again 0.7 volts. This result in the 3.6 volts DC to power up the filaments. Of course, is not the correct process. The ideal process is use AC voltage, but to make the test, this is enough. The other 5 volts DC coming from the power source is responsible to power up the driver of the VFD. The Arduino only connects the GND and the communication ports or pins to the panel. The connections I made to bring the panel to life again is present in these two levels of the pins, and you can see here the filament 1, filament 2, data in, clock and data out. After you have strobe in the second level, this is not connected, I don't use this wire here, VSS or GND, the voltage to the filaments and grids, in this case is used less 24 volts, and VDD has 5 volts DC. This is the front of the glass, or the VFD. You have here a receptor of the infrared, and the pinout of the infrared receiver is in this point here. You can check in the schematic the remaining pins. Now, about the map of the RAM related with each grid. You can see the grid 1, in this case, is the first symbols at the left side, this point here. You have 3 bytes related with the filaments, byte 0, byte 1, byte 2. The second grid starts in the byte 3, 4 and 5. The grid 3 starts in the byte 6, 7 and 8 and so on. You can see at this point here I need to skip two grids because they have some different connections in the board, and these two grids or these two blocks of the RAM map related with these grids is not used. They skip to the byte 12, to the grid 5, and 15 to the grid 6, and 18 to the grid 7. Okay, this is a skip implemented by the hardware connection. And after, in this side, you can see the positions of the grid, grid 1, grid 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. But the wording is not related directly with the byte or the sequence of the bytes, because you see the map to this grid starts at byte 1, 2, okay? It's not 12, it's the 1, 2 hexadecimal. Here is the same, 1, 5 hexadecimal, 1, 8 hexadecimal. You see here the quantity of the bytes used to this process. Okay, this is the datasheet of the PT6315-S. This is a DIP 28 format. This is 11 pins to control the driver. And here you have the section of the commands. You can see the command 1 to adjust the setting mode of display start with 00 and have 4 digits to define the number of digits and segments. In this case we are using in this panel the set digits 7 digits and 9 segments. Okay, after you have the map of the RAM and you can see each grid or digit use 3 bytes to fill the segments of this grid. But pay attention, if you look here you can check they only send 4 bits or only use 4 bits in each byte they send. Okay, 4 bits in the first byte, 4 in the second, and 4 in the third. And you can see the last byte, the bits used is the bits present in the middle. After you have the command 2, and this command 2 define the status or the operation you want to do it to the driver. Write to display, read the keys. If you increment the address of the RAM every time you write a byte, if it's a normal operation in test mode, this is common too. This is a matrix of possible of the keys, and the common tree define the address of the RAM block. You know, if you start the address 00, you write to the first grid. The first grid have the 00, 01, 02. The second grid will start in the 03, 4 and 5. And the next grid or digit will be the 6 and so on, okay? The command 4 control the pulse of the display and define if the display is on or off. This adjust the bright of the display. After you have the fluxogram of the communication, but okay, you can reach this information reading data sheet is present in the web. Now, if you go to the code, I start with the this function here, where we define the initialization of the PT6315-S. I need a delay to a secure start of the driver. After I send the command to define 7 grids in this case, or 7 digits. After I send the increment address mode and the mode normal of the display. After I send the address where we'll start fill the RAM block, and at last we send the bright of the VFD. In this case the VFD is on, and I add 3 bits, the last 3 bits, to put the maximum of the bright. This is important to fill the to start the initialization of the VFD driver. And after, in the loop, okay, you have a lot of functions. They are called with the each process you want, but this is very basic. Okay, clear of the all segments. I write a fixed grid. Send the word bellow, the word job, word end, and fun, and final. I do a small loop to write a fixed shards in the grids. Clear again, make a delay, and return to the process. Okay, this is all you need do it to bring the panel again to life.